Hey friends, my name is Cody and I'm with LaunchDarkly. And in this LaunchDarkly at Lightspeed video, I want to take you on a Mach 3 tour of my favorite demo. Let's jump in and take a look. I always started this application in this way. It's running in Netlify. I use Netlify in this example because it's really easy for me to push my code into GitHub, have it automatically build in Netlify and pop out so I can share it with everybody so everybody can demo it as well. In this case, the app starts up as the common app delivery flow, this idea of building something locally, right? I'm building in VS Code and I'm pushing it up into GitHub in this case. Netlify is taking that, deploying it out, and then people are able to consume it. But how does this change when we start to bring LaunchDarkly in the picture? That's what I focus on in this demo. So right out of the gate, I want to go ahead and bring in the standard header feature flag. So I turn this on and we can see things change a little bit. We're getting a new header for this configuration. We're talking about shipping and releasing features faster. I love it. Everyone loves it. It's a great time. From here, I go in and I turn on this QR code display. Now this one might work or might not work based on when you're watching this video, but typically I have this up so that people can view it from their phone. They can scan this QR code, bring it up on their device and be able to watch and follow along with me, which is really fun for showing feature flags changing across multiple devices. Now I do something special with this feature flag though, and if I go into it, we can see the details. I have a targeting rule in place that hides this feature flag on mobile devices. So if I scan that code and bring it up on my device, you're not going to see that QR code because I can use targeting to enable or disable features based on specific attributes that are in play. From here, I bring in the Logon UI. So I go in, enable this feature, and take a look at it inside of my UI, and we can see the logon page is there. I can use this to start bringing in custom usernames and be able to target off of those usernames as well. In this case, I have this targeting around an upper image feature flag. So I'll turn this on and it's set up for only users inside of a segment. The segment in LaunchDarkly is a group of users who we might use for targeting. So in this case, dev users are gonna see this new image feature. I'm going to go ahead and save this change and we'll jump into segments and take a look at dev users. Anyone who starts with C or B is going to get this. So if I switch back in, we can see the current anonymous user is getting nothing. But if I go in and log in with Cody, I get that new image up top. Again, as I scan this, it's going to show up in the application on the mobile device as well. So we've shown how to target things off of something like a segment and be able to scale to a large amount of users. We're gonna move on now. We're gonna bring in this logo update feature flag. Now this is where I like to show the idea of a progressive rollout. So in this case, I've changed the default rule to be a percentage rollout and said 50-50 between the toggle image and the LaunchDarkly logo. If I turn this feature on, 50% of the users who signed in my application are gonna receive this change. I'll save this and jump back in. And we can see I'm getting the original logo here. Let's maybe change this to Bruce and see what happens. Bruce now is getting the toggle image show up. So we're getting a different image based on different users. And again, that's 50% of the users who are consuming my platform are getting different images. This is what we talk about when we talk about progressively rolling out new features in an environment. I can set this to gradually increase. I can maybe go up to 60% instead. If I want to automate this, I can come into workflows, create a workflow around that progressive rollout and have this be automated over a certain period of time. This gives a ton of flexibility in automating the way we roll out changes inside of an environment. If I'm happy with that feature, I might go into that logo update and change the new default to always be the toggle image. So the new default is turned on. And if I save it now, all users are going to receive that toggle image. Finally, at the end of it all, we come back and we want to talk about that original targeting concept that I showed, targeting a specific user with a change. So I might come in here and say, instead of that targeting rule I have right now, delete that rule, but maybe I want to target a specific user. And I want to say it's maybe something like Jake receives this updated feature flag. I'll turn this on and you'll see here I have a prerequisite setup that's been shown in a couple of other items so far. This prerequisite is what allows me to link feature flags together. So I'm able to say that in order for this feature flag to be turned on, the standard header has to be turned on as well. If the other one's turned off, but I turn this one on, this change won't make it through. So I'm going to review and save. Save this change. Switch back in. We can see nothing's changed here. If I go in and change this to Jake, We can see those new cards showing up. Why did the image up top disappear? Because they weren't part of, Jake is not a part of that segment that was configured. If I jump back into LaunchDarkly, hit my users, I can come in and look at Bruce and see the feature flags that he's receiving in this case. The attributes that come in are key Bruce, his browser device, and he's coming in from a macOS system, and these are all the feature flags that he's configured to receive. I could target those changes specifically to him here. For example, I could come in and say, I do want Bruce to receive this change. We're now making this specific change to the specific user. Review and save, go back into the application, change this to Bruce, and now Bruce is receiving all of those changes. This Lightspeed video is really meant to show you how I move through a very quick demo showing the concept of targeting changes at users and gradually rolling things out. There's a ton more of capabilities in the LaunchDarkly platform that we can show, everything from experimentation to scheduling changes and other ways to automate the way we roll things out to users. I'm really excited to show you more. Let me know the things you want to see. Have a great day.